New York's almost as big as New England. There's New York State, and if you notice, upstate is the majority of the state, and we'll focus in on downstate. That's downstate right there. See? Long Island.
Here we have from Western New York, a representative for the Assembly, Steve Hawley, and you had some proposal about separating upstate from downstate and putting a referendum for each county, is it?
The way it would work is the legislation is very specific. It doesn't, it's non-controversial.
Non-binding, you said?
Non-binding. It would allow each county in the state of New York to place a non-binding initiative on the county ballots in November. And it would allow citizens in the state of New York, which is a unusual thing, to get citizens' input and opinions, especially with regard to how the SAFE Act went down in the middle of the night, where no one was asked a question. The governor invoked his prerogative, message of necessity, waived the 3-day rule of having legislation on an elected representative's desk. Didn't want the input from anyone, and just pushed it right through. We don't want to do that. We want to ask people what their opinion is on having the possibility of two New Yorks. And so what would happen is each of the counties in the state of New York would be able to put on the ballot in November a very simple question for every voter to vote on. Should New York be divided into two states? Simple yes or no.
Upstate and downstate, you know.
Doesn't identify that. That's why it's not controversial. Non-adversarial. It's asking our citizens, the people of the state of New York, what they think about that idea. Is it possible to have two New Yorks? Where would the line be drawn? Some people talk about New York City as their own entity unto themselves. And in many ways they are. But you can't fault them because they're all representing their constituents' needs, wants, and desires, just like we do in upstate New York. Ironically, just like the representatives from Long Island, which in upstate, many people think of Long Island and New York as being one. Not so much, because the Long Island representatives, Assemblyman Fred Thiel, has a piece of legislation that would allow Long Island to become a different state.
Also, Staten
Island also has had, for the last 25 years, a movement to make Staten Island not a borough of New York City. So there is a hue and cry, if you will. We don't know what the result of that hue and cry would be until we allow people to actually vote on a very simple, non-binding question. Do you think New York ought to be divided into two states? I happen to think that all of New York's citizens would vote the majority that we should be, because we really are. The New York City area, whether you want to include Long Island or not, which is not a borough of New York City, but close, that's where the vast majority of people in the state live. We operate under one person, one vote. We have 60-some-odd percent of the population in that area. And north of Westchester County, let's say, we have 38 to 42% of the population. So when you have that kind of proliferation of population in a singular geographic area, that's where the votes come from. Theoretically, 60-some-odd percent of all of the assemblymen come out of that area of the state. And so it's very difficult, whether you're Republican or Democrat, male, female, state senator, assemblyman, very, very difficult to get much of anything done in a meaningful way for the economy, for education spending, equitable education spending.
Ballparks?
They
get a billion for one?
Right, ballparks, gasoline prices, taxes, property taxes, income taxes.
We difference people, in cost of living is way different too.
Throughway tolls, spending on roads and bridges. New York State is a huge state. When I went to college a number of years ago out in Ohio, people, when I told them I was from New York State, automatically assumed that I was from New York City. And really the only way I could convince them how large the state was is to tell them that it took me 5 hours, roughly, to drive from my home in Batavia, New York, to Toledo, Ohio. But it took me 6 to 6.5 hours to drive from Batavia, New York, to New York City in Manhattan. That allowed them to understand that not everyone from New York State was from New York City. And I think oftentimes people from a specific area, especially elected representatives, will look, rightfully so, at their own district, which might be 4 blocks in the New York City area versus my district, which
right
is
out
from Monroe County through Orleans and used to include Niagara County and then all of Genesee. People that live in the Adirondack region, sometimes it's 4.5 to 5 hours to get from one end of their assembly district to the other, one person, one vote. So it's an interesting scenario that we have in this state. And I don't think any other state, maybe Chicago, Illinois with Chicago, California has a lot of people, but they have a lot of major metropolitan areas in that state. We don't so much. We have some cities that have populations, Buffalo and Rochester and Syracuse and Binghamton and Albany and others, but the vast majority of the population in this state is downstate. That's the reason that we have the Medicaid problems that we have. Could we, wherever that line is drawn, could we actually survive? What kind of new York would we have? I don't think we'd have the Medicaid burden that we have currently in this state. $55 billion a year spent on Medicaid. More than California, Texas, and North Carolina combined.
More than the whole budgets of some states.
Correct. And our budget's $136 billion, unless you had the Hurricane Sandy relief, and then it's over the 140 mark. But when you have that kind of expense, pretty much every optional program offered, optional, the key word, New York has. We need to take care of people in their time of need, in their hour of need, in their week or two or month, whatever it may be. But it's not necessary, from my point of view, because of the financial burden that it puts on counties that pay 25% of the cost with no input whatsoever. I don't think that's fair to the residents, the hard-working people of the state of New York, to burden them with this $55 billion Medicaid boondoggle. California has more people than we have. Texas has more people than we have. Yet our program is more than the Medicaid burden of California, Texas, and North Carolina. So it is really two New Yorks. Again, I'd like to say that you can't really fault the people who represent individuals in the boroughs of New York City or any larger metropolitan area.
They're just different. They're not wrong.
They're different. That's right. We worry about gas prices. We worry about thruway tolls. We worry about the water that we have in these great lakes just north of where we're sitting right now.
Finger Lakes too.
Finger Lakes also. We worry about many different issues than people from the greater New York City area. So it's an interesting discussion. I don't know whether we could be, wherever that line is drawn, could be two New Yorks or not. I just think we'd operate a new New York very, very differently than the current New York State.